All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining now is Kenneth MacLeod, the CEO of Sonoro Gold Corp. And Ken, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Hello, Steve. Great to see you too.
Yeah, so another big milestone for the company, announcing your preliminary economic assessment on Cerro Caliche, which of course is in Mexico. First off, a lot of work getting to this point, Ken.
It was a huge amount of work. There's a grand total of 55,000 meters of drilling that's been assayed and analyzed in the PEA. And so that amounts to 500 drill holes, an average length of 110 meters. But I want to emphasize that what we've been focusing on is the shallow oxide deposit that is near surface to the point where the average depth of the drill holes is about 60 to 70 meters. So this makes us very excited to be able to say we do have the potential now for going into production early in order to start generating revenue, which will enable us to continue with the drilling program and be able to expand that resource even to a greater extent than what we currently have, and also explore for the potential for a deeper underground type resource as well.
Yeah. Ken, you talk about the shallowness of it, and that really shows in the PEA. The initial startup costs are a lot less than you would normally see. Is that the reason for that?
Yeah, we took a really good hard look at the capital costs. Now, a year ago, I would have come to you, Steve, and said the capital costs are going to be close to $30, $35 million. But because of the distressed state of the markets over the past year or two, we've taken a cold, sober look at the dilution to the shareholders that would emanate from having a large CapEx arrangement at this point in time. And so we decided that we would start off smaller, 4,000 tons per day facility, which would then be increased at the end of year two to 12,000 tons per day. That has enabled us to cut down on capital costs per se. But more importantly, we've been able to strike a deal with the crusher distributors in Mexico, where we end up leasing the crusher, leasing to purchase the initial 4,000 ton per day, which would be replaced in year two, for the 12,000 ton a day crusher, which we then lease to purchase over a period of time. And that enabled us to effectively cut down somewhere in the order of about $8 million in the initial capital costs. Then other aspects of the size of the leach pad and the installation of the transmission line, we're delaying some of these additional capital costs into years two, three, and four, because then they'll be paid for out of cash flow. So all in all, $15.5 million of initial capital, which would then be supplemented by an additional $15.5 million of capital out of cash flow. So that enables us to start off with a very, very modest capital cost up front.
Yeah. And we should also mention that we're talking about a fairly small area right now looking at, and there's exploration still going on to really sort of see the what you hope is the potential for what Cerro Caliche can really be.
Well, there are several aspects to the potential for Cerro Caliche. One, of course, is SRK estimated in their resource analysis that within the pit shells as they're currently constituted, we have approximately 440,000 mineable ounces. And then outside of the pit shells and within essentially a stone's throw, I would say, it's up to an additional 275,000 ounces. And they didn't incorporate those into the pit shell simply because the drill spacing in some of these holes was a little too wide. So, you know, obviously it stands to reason that if you do some additional infill drilling there, you should be able to, in the foreseeable future, be able to draw those into the pit shells. And the potential is for 700,000 ounces within the pit shells currently, plus that potential, that gives you a very robust start to the mining process for Cerro Caliche. But outside of that, we've identified numerous zones where the potential for mineralization is extremely high. And some limited drilling has occurred in these zones, but certainly a lot of mapping and surface sampling has occurred to give us the encouragement and give us the opportunity to assess that the potential as it stands currently is that we've only drilled maybe less than 30% of the known mineralized zones in the property. So we have a high degree of confidence that the resource will expand in a significant way over the coming years. And there are, you know, two ways that we want to continue with the drilling program. One, of course, is out of cash flow once we get into production. And the other one is to take a smaller scale initial drill program to further expand upon the high-grade zones that have been identified by SRK. And we fully expect that they will yield a great return for us as we expand upon these high-grade zones.
All right. Well, it's going to be interesting moving forward, and this is a great start to it. The PEA out now. Ken, thanks so much. Good to update everything on what's going on, and we look forward to our next conversation, okay?
Thank you, Steve. A real pleasure.
Okay. All right. Bye-bye. Ken MacLeod, the CEO of Sonoro Gold Corp.